Live from the Times Union Center, it's Levack and Goz on 104.5 The Team.
Big open house today at the Times Union Center because the Arena Football League is back. We don't know the name of the team yet, but everybody's rocking these really cool orange ties, and no exception, the man to my right now, Coach Rob Keefe with us. Coach, welcome to the Capital Region.
Yeah, pleasure to be here. You know, really excited to be in the Capital Region, and we've been here for about the last 3 days, me and the coaching staff, getting the lay of the land, you know, getting to know everybody, and really excited for tonight.
Now, you have the distinction of being the only Arena player slash coach to win titles as a player and coach at both A1 and A2.
Yeah, very fortunate. Very fortunate to be on a lot of great teams. And obviously there's a, you know, the ultimate, teamwork, which is football, just to be around a lot of great people. And so I was very fortunate to be on those teams, and it kind of fell in that way. But, four championships, and got to learn a lot too. You know, there were some times where I was a head coach. I was an assistant coach. I was the captain of the team, and I was a role player. So got to see all facets of all those championships, which has helped me as a coach to this day.
Take us through the process. How did you end up finding out you're going to be the head coach of the Albany Arena football team?
Yeah, great process. So what made me feel good about it as well, it was a phone call to me. And which I felt good, you know, I felt wanted, and that's always a good thing. And then, you know, you can't lie about that it felt good to get that phone call. And I got it from the Philadelphia Soul ownership. Phil Bogle, who's the general manager of the Philadelphia Soul, was putting together a list for the Philadelphia Soul ownership, called me. We go way back, winning a championship at the Soul in 2008. And then it was a process over about 3 month process where, had a phone interviews, then in-person interviews. Then we came up to Albany to meet the ownership group and, you know, narrowed the list down and won the job. And could be more thrilled. And now being here, right, it's real, it's in person, and it's something tangible. And I'm really excited about that.
We got Coach Rob Keefe with us right now. Now I'm gonna throw your words at you.
Sure.
With all due respect to the other arena football teams, I expect to win the first year. That's the expectation every year.
Absolutely.
All right, come on. You don't even know where your team is yet, Coach.
And that's the first year. Just being in this building right now, it's going to be rocking. And this is going to be the ultimate home field advantage. And I'll say this, and again, not a knock to the other teams. A big reason why I took the job, where I think the ownership's going to be great. The first thing the ownership talked to me about was how, you know, it's a void that's missing in the community. It's something that they really want to give to the people of Albany. They talked about job creation, just everything you want to hear in an owner. Like this, it's just great stuff. But at the same time, everywhere where I've been successful, and not a knock on the other teams, but, you know, in Philadelphia, great organization, right? You got the Phillies, you got the Eagles, you got the 76ers. This is the ticket. You know, this is the place to be. And with that said, as you tie all that in together from a recruiting standpoint, this is where players want to play. Players want to play in a place like this where they feel like this is home. The fans have their support. That'll get the players here. And then we put a great coaching staff together that's going to make sure the players are in the right position to be successful. I think it has all the makeups of being a championship-winning team in the first season.
You brought up that recruiting process. Does that mean you can take teams away from other arena footballing teams? You have to have a full tryout. What is that like?
Yeah, so we'll have tryouts. We'll have open workouts. We'll find those diamonds in the rough on January 27th. We're going to have a workout in Albany, an open tryout, where we'll probably have 400 to 500 players, and we'll find those diamonds in the rough. And on top of that, when the recruiting process does start, which it really kind of has already, where we have our lists, there'll be, this is the way I put it, you know, there's 360 million people in America. There's 2,000 on a given year that play in the NFL. There's a lot of talent out there, and there's a lot of guys that have just got cut by the Giants and the Jets and the Patriots that are saying, look, I got to continue these skills. Hey, this is where you come to arena football, and you come to Albany, and we're going to make sure that you have a home here. And so we'll bring 45 to 50 guys into camp. You whittle that down to 25 guys, but they'll be the best 25 that we could possibly put on the field. And look, in that, that's really what it's all about. But it's a recruiting process. It's not a draft. You don't have a dispersal draft. You don't have anything like that. So we have to sell the arena. We have to sell the housing here. We have to sell the people here in the region. And I think with energy that we have in our coaching staff, the guys know how to recruit and know how to coach, I think we'll put a great team together.
Coach Rob Keefe with us right now as we get ready for the open house, 5 o'clock tonight. Everybody come out, free to get in, free parking, the whole nine. So you've won multiple titles. You played A2, A1. We've hosted A2 and A1.
Yes.
When you look around the TU Center, and how does it stack up to the other arenas?
This is AFL all the way. This is AF1 all the way. And the reason why I say that is because, again, sometimes you'll be in these big cities, right? And they'll have these arenas that are 22,000, 25,000 people. And that's all good and well. And if you stack that, hey, that's a bonus. But this is intimate. You know, when you have 13, 14,000 people, and first off, it's going to be loud. I'm telling you, this is how good we get as you get a coach when you're in an arena. I'm looking at the walls. I'm looking at the concrete. I'm looking at how that noise isn't going anywhere. That noise is staying in the arena. It's going to be so loud, you know, in here when we're on defense. And I know that's a knowledgeable crowd already because they know arena football. It's going to be super quiet on offense. But yeah, this is everything that you want it to be. And I'm telling you, this is where players want to play. Players want to play in an environment that's crazy. It's loud. It's fan friendly. It's interactive. And I think this has all the makeups on it. This is AFL one to the fullest.
Coach, I just wish you had some energy.
Yeah, man. And I tell you what, you know, when you say from a recruiting standpoint, you know, the players, they want to know that they're cared about. They want to know that they're loved. They want to make sure that the coaches are going to do everything for them. And, you know, we try to bring in every single day for them so we win every single week.
We got Coach Rob Keefe with us right now. So the recruiting process is very interesting to me. So you said, you know, guys are getting cut from the Giants, Jets, and
sure,
New England, wherever. Is there, you've already got a list. Is there a guy right now that if I get him, everything's going to fall into place?
Yeah, you know, and I will say this without giving it away, but we'll say there's three kind of players that will be here. There'll be players that have had great experience in the NFL that possibly have got cut. And what happens is, unlike basketball and unlike baseball, you have to continue to play. You know, baseball, we can go to the batting cages, get some fielding work. Basketball, you can have that personal trainer that can keep you in shape, and you can run up and down the court with anyone that when you find an open gym. Football, it's like if a year and a half goes by, you're really not playing football. You're kind of a gym rat. You're just lifting. You're not really playing football. So we have that speech to those guys that, hey, look, you haven't played for the Patriots in a year and a half. Let's get you back on the field so then you can get that call back to you. So you'll have that guy with NFL experience. You'll have the AFL vet that have played for 5 to 7 years that literally know the game inside and out. You know, they're at that 27 to 29 range that are just an AFL solid veteran. They know how the ins and outs of the game, and they're really good, and it's unfortunate maybe they haven't had a shot yet in the NFL. And then you'll have guys fresh out of college, guys that literally maybe didn't get a shot in the NFL and are saying, well, hey, what do I do next? Well, this is the option. You know, this is what I want to say. If you have 32 teams in the NFL, I want to be the 33rd best team in the NFL. That's how great I want this team to be. And so we'll have a great recruiting process, but we have lists. I mean, we have lists that are 10 deep at every single position that we want to have at what we call our 5-star. Then we got a 10 deep in the 4-star, 10 deep in the 3-star for every single position all across the board. And the coaches do a great job of putting that together. And we're just waiting to pick up the phone and get those guys here.
That was a nice answer, Coach. The correct answer was Levack and I.
Yes. 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 Yes, absolutely. Offensive line right here, starting O-line.
That's right.
Yes.
Yeah, your staff came in, took a look at Harambe and Goz and I, and thought, you know, we're ready to go.
I'm telling you, we got left tackle, guard, fullback. That's right there.
Perfect. There you go.
Absolutely.
You're talking about the rest of your staff. Who are some of your other coaches on that staff?
Well, we put a great staff together. So we'll have one that we'll introduce tonight that I'm really excited about. And the two gentlemen that are here behind me, Chris Thompson, a great coach. He's going to be our offensive coordinator, director of football operations, has had a great year or years as a head coach, Lehigh Valley Steelhawks, very innovative offensive coordinator. He's going to put up a lot of points on the board, kind of the quarterback whisperer. And you need a guy like that knows how to work hands out with the offensive skill positions and run a fluid offense. That's a big deal in arena football. It is very, very, heavy offensive friendly. I mean, scores of 70 and 80 points. I mean, that's where the fans really enjoy it. So you want to make sure you have an offensive coordinator that knows what he's doing. And then Les Moss, our assistant head coach, I couldn't be more proud to have him on staff. So, his father is, when you win the Coach of the Year trophy, it's named after his father, Perry Moss, who has been head coach of Florida State at one time, head coach of Marshall, and Les himself has won Coach of the Year a number of times in the Arena Football League. We've had battles when I was the Orlando Predator head coach and he was the Jacksonville Shark head coach, but over 32 years of arena football experience. I mean, this is what a great staff. And so we'll have a coach that will come in tonight that we'll introduce that has played in the Arena Football League for a long time and just known as one of the best defensive players in the Arena Football League to add to that staff. And the reason why you have only four coaches is because you only have about 25 guys on the team. And so, again, a small coaching staff, it's really like that kind of basketball feel or maybe a baseball feel where it's not 15 guys on the sideline. So we're really intimate. So for me, I'll be the head coach, I'll be the defensive coordinator, and also be the defensive backs coach. And then we'll all have a special team that we work, really hands-on with, and that's how you break up the staff. And so it's a lot of 18-hour days, but we love it every single minute of it, and we're going to do it so we get wins every Saturday night.
All right, Coach, before we let you go, I got to ask you the tough question about the Arena Football League.
Sure.
Cleveland not going to play for 2 years. What does that do to you guys?
For me personally, look, I always turn everything into a positive. So it doesn't affect us. And at the end of the day, we want to make sure that all of our partners are in a good position. So I understood it. This wasn't Cleveland doesn't want to leave us. Cleveland says, look, we have, pressure from the county commissioners and the mayors where we're saying, hey, at the queue where LeBron James plays, we got to get that thing up to code. If we don't get that thing up to code, we can't have anything in here. So they recognize that by building building that, you know, those that, I guess you say the new structure within there, it would affect the arena football season. So if we can take 2 years off to get this building right, so by the time Cleveland comes back in, you know, the queue is rocking and rolling. So I know they'll probably talk tonight with, you know, Ron Jaworski and all these guys that are coming here to kind of address the crowd, where there's a lot of expansion on the horizon. For me personally, as a coach, there's a lot of Cleveland players that want to be here. You know, that's the way I look at it. There's a lot of people that want to jump on the Albany bandwagon. So for us, look, if it's two teams, if it's 20 teams, if we're playing in the arena or playing in the parking lot, our job is to be as competitive as possible to put on a great show and make sure that we represent Albany to the fullest, and that's what we're going to do.
Coach Rob Keefe, man, we're happy to have you here. Everybody come out, meet the man who's gonna lead our guys. And do you, like, I know you can't say, but like, do you have any, we wanted to call the team the Nightmares. We thought,
put it to you this way, I'll tell you this, the fans did an awesome job at picking the name. So I have an idea of what the name is. I think it's going to make the region proud. It's going to make the city proud. I was really inspired, and it was an overwhelming majority of what the name was picked. So we're really excited about that. We're really excited to announce kind of all the colors. And obviously you're getting a feel for it, right, because everybody's wearing orange ties.
Yep.
So they're kind of giving a little away. But they're doing a good job, too, because they want to have the jersey unveiling. They want to have the name unveiling.
Right.
You know, they want to do it the right way to get people pumped up for the season. And I'm excited when that name comes. We'll be rocking and rolling.
So this $20 bill right here can't change it to the Nightmare?
No, the $20. No, sir.
No,
sir.
All right.
I appreciate the offer, though.
I had to give it a try. Coach Messler, we are really excited
Thanks,
to have
guys.
You here.
Yeah.
And, I'll be right here. So get that first championship for us right
now. Awesome. Thank you so much, guys. It's an honor to be here.